includes human beings, animals, and environment, consisting of living and non-living things, depend on one another in some sort. This reliance is important for the existence of all of us and is scientifically termed as the eco-sheltering system. When this sheltering system deteriorates, it is expected that natural calamities will occur and result in endangering the existence of all living and non-living things around us. However, we have all polluted our natural environment in different measures, and one of the most critical measures includes the heavy use of plastic bags. Nowadays, plastic bags are conveniently used for packing and carrying things around in people's daily lives. These bags are light, bought at a cheap price, and can be disposed of so easily that the world's consumption of them reaches 50,000 billion bags a year. It is evident that our supermarkets, groceries, markets, restaurants, tea shops, street hawkers, and so forth are using these plastic bags in masses. Although these plastic bags may serve our needs for packing and carrying things at a convenience, the use of them generates a lot of disadvantages. What are these disadvantages? The moment people dispose plastic bags that are of no use to them anymore, we are faced with a number of problems. First and foremost, the plastic bags that have been disposed hastily end up on the sides of the motor roads, railways, rivers, markets, backyards, and so many other places. This litter is still seen everywhere for the longest time since they do not wear away instantly. As a result, the once clean and beautiful city is dirtied with the now useless presence of these plastic bags. On top of this, the waste in these bags serve as a source of housing for rats, mosquitoes, flies, cockroaches, and namely insects that can carry and spread unsanitary bacteria diseases. Plus, any water that is remaining in these used plastic bags supports the reproduction of mosquitoes that are today's most responsible dengue fever carriers. These are just a few of many reasons why we should not dispose our used plastic bags heedlessly. When the monsoon season comes, these deserted used plastic bags drift along the ditches and sewers, eventually blocking the water current and leading to flooding our roads. The heavily flooded roads disturb the commuting motor vehicles and pedestrians, and are certainly a safety hazard for everyone. What's more is these plastic bags are bound to continue to drift to waters, creeks, and last but not the least, the sea. Some nations dispose their waste, including these plastic bags, into the seas, contaminating the water and harming the sea creatures and plants. From recent observations, whales, dolphins, otters, crocodiles, turtles, and sea creatures alike mistake the plastic bags for food. The intake of these plastic bags block their digestive systems, and these creatures end up dying from internal injuries. For instance, these used plastic bags look like jellyfish when they are floating in water, and turtles have died from mistakenly eating plastic bags in the water. Likewise, these events are not only found true among water creatures, but also found true among the land creatures and flocks of birds. With these acknowledged, it is fit to say that plastic bags deteriorate the eco-sheltering system to a large extent. People would never expect plastic bags could ultimately harm our big environment. However, just considering all the different problems the use of plastic bags leads to, it is important that we look into the matter and evaluate why the problems have been caused. Why do plastic bags cause problems? The answer is simply that these plastic bags are made of polyethylene plastic, which cannot be worn away for 500 to 1,000 years. People's waste and litter, including these used plastic bags, are collected by the city's garbage trucks and deserted in areas outside the city's vicinity. Over time, other waste are decomposed and turn out to be soil in the end, It is not the case for plastic bags. The scenery here is an old garbage area, and we can see how the other waste have corroded along with time. But the used plastic bags still remain uncorroded. These used plastic bags do not decompose, neither in ground nor in water, but remain even as tiny particles to continue to pollute both our earth and waters. When plastic bags are present in the ground, they will weaken the fertility of the soil, in turn affecting the growth of plants. So it is very important that plastic bags are not disposed in the proximity of cultivation and plantation areas. Then why are these plastic bags not burned for disposal? Burning them will unquestionably instigate greater risk than anticipated. When plastic bags are burned, ethylene oxide-like dioxin vapors are released into the environment. If one inhales this vapor, it permeates into the person's blood and urinal system and impairs the reproductive system. It is also found that one can be diagnosed with cancer as a result of inhaling the vapor. Besides this, the vapor is prone to pollute the atmosphere and even damage our ozone layer. For that reason, it would create greater risk to us if we were to burn these plastic bags. Another striking finding on plastic bags is that the chemicals and dyeing materials contained therein, when touched with heat, incite lead and poisonous chemicals. When hot food and drinks are put into these plastic bags, these poisonous chemicals are found to mix with them and can be harmful to us sooner or later. This is why it is best to avoid our habits of using plastic bags. The plastic seed used in producing these plastic bags cannot be recycled and is made from valuable crude oil. Annual disposing of used plastic bags of the world totals about 50 billion bags, and this is just equal to wasting nearly 60 million barrels of valuable crude oil each year without any benefits, but to generate risk to the environment in great measures. It is crucial that there is a drastic reduction in the use of plastic bags to prevent polluting of our environment and to act upon maintaining our natural resources. How will we solve this problem concerning plastic bags? Refuse. We have to refuse to use plastic bags as much as we can. When there were no plastic bags before, we used baskets, garment bags, and some sort of hand carriers to carry or pack groceries, things, and many more. Likewise, when we packed our food, we used plantain leaves, in leaves, newspapers, card boxes, which wears away easily. These older habits were proper and suited our environment, so we ought to refuse the use of plastic bags. Reuse. When we do our groceries or go shopping or even carry our things, we ought to reuse the old plastic bags we already have in order to reduce the use of any more plastic bags. Reduce. In order to reduce the usage of the plastic bags, we ought to replace plastic bags with garment bags made from cotton or jute. These garment bags conform to the environment and can wear away without leaving any bits and pieces to our earth's ground or water, and do not produce any harmful chemicals of any sort either. Some supermarkets today have taken the step to provide garment bags in an attempt to encourage people to substitute those bags, which can be washed and reused multiple times to reduce the usage of plastic bags. If one uses these bags for a week, we will reduce the usage by 6 plastic bags on average, 24 in a month, and 228 in the year. Yangon's population of nearly 6 million can reduce the use of 1,368 million plastic bags annually. Recycle. The cost of recycling the used plastic bags is so much that it is impossible to make any profit out of the recycling as well. As a result, The whole world can only manage to recycle 1% of them. The Yangon City Development Committee collects these disposed plastic bags to make dustbins. Currently, some international communities ban the use of plastic bags, collect taxes on the use of plastic bags, or allow the usage of plastic bags that are the least thick. Ireland was able to reduce the use of plastic bags by 90% by collecting taxes. Bangladesh has banned the use of plastic bags ever since 2002. China has only allowed the use of plastic bags with a certain thickness, and plastic bags are not given out for free. Rwanda has enacted an actual plastic control law. In some states of India, manufacturing and sale of plastic bags are banned. Israel, Canada, Kenya, South Africa, and Singapore are considering banning the use of plastic bags as well. Keeping in mind the uncountable problems the use of plastic bags generates and observing the many people from the different nations throughout the world acting to stop the use of plastic bags, it is also important that we do our part on our end by refusing to use any plastic bags. It is a collaborative effort to meet one common objective, the goal to ensure our world remains safe and beautiful for our children, our children's children, and all upcoming generations. So refuse and say no to using plastic bags starting today.